Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is good all the time and all the time. God is good. So here we are once again in the book of Philippians, continuing to talk about the goodness of Jesus. And so here we are in Philippians chapter 2, verse 6, where the Apostle Paul, through the power of the Holy Spirit, tells us this: who being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God. Hallelujah. So this is one of the strongest statements in all the Bible that attests to the deity of Jesus Christ, right? So remember the last video we talked about, the previous verse where Paul instructed us to let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. So now he talks about who being in the form of God thought it not robbery to be equal with God. So this tells us that Jesus Christ is God. Hallelujah. Because that word robbery, it has the meaning of a thing to be held on to, a thing to cling to. So Jesus Christ is God manifested in the flesh. There was never a time in history, okay, and before history, when it was just him, where Jesus Christ stopped being God. Okay. He was always and will always be God. Even when he was born as a baby, he was God. Okay, when the Holy Spirit came upon Mary with the holy seed and implanted into Mary's egg, okay, Jesus Christ was fully God at that moment in time. There was never a point in time where Jesus Christ still wasn't fully God. He was 100% God, 100% man at the same time when he incarnated, okay? And he'll forever be 100% God and 100% man forever, okay? And so this is a proof text that we could use to prove the deity of Jesus Christ. It goes along with John 1:1. You know, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, right? There's so many different proof texts that prove that Jesus Christ is God. In John 8:58, right? Before Abraham was, I am. Okay, identifying himself with the same name, okay, that was revealed to Moses at the burning bush. I am, right? And so when Jesus said that, they took up stones to stone him, right? Because him being a man made himself out to be God. And that's who he is. He is God. Hallelujah. And so we can rest on the 100% truth that Jesus Christ is deity. Okay, he's the only God. Okay, in the Old Testament, and I think it's in Isaiah, where God says, there is none else. He knows not another. Okay, there is no other God. He doesn't know. And God knows everything. He said, there's no other God. I don't know any other God. Okay, like him, no. There's no one like him. Right? And God knows everything. So you want to talk about multiple universes. You want to talk about, you know, this, that, and the third. You know, you want to get all existential and get all metaphysical. There's no other creator out there. Okay, there's only one. And his name is Jesus Christ. That's it. That's all. He's the only one who can take nothing and make it into something. Okay. He is the end all, be all. That's why he calls himself the Aleph and the Tav, right? The Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. And there's no one else. And so we worship him. We worship Jesus Christ, the living God, Alpha and Omega. Amen. Because he's worthy of all of our praise. Look what he did. Okay. Look at the beautiful masterpiece he made in you. Right. Look at the beautiful masterpiece that he made in you. Right. Look at the new creation that he made in you. Right. All you have to do is look at the mirror and see how he fashioned you. Right. And then look in the mirror. Right. And see how he's transformed you. Look at the creative power of God. Right. Everything is beautifully and wonderfully made. He made us beautifully and wonderfully. All we have to do is look in the mirror to see that. Okay? And the Bible tells us, hallelujah, the Bible tells us that because he's the creator, he has something that's just mind-blowing beyond description, because we're going to actually see him. Hallelujah. We're going to actually see him after the last day, when he casts all the wicked into hell. Well, he casts all the wicked into the lake of fire. Hell is going to be put into the lake of fire. But he puts all the wicked, all those in darkness, he puts them into the lake of fire forever. Sucks to be them. But we're actually going to see him after that create a new heaven and a new earth. Hallelujah. And God says it's going to be all ours. It's going to be all ours forever and ever. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? My goodness. We could imagine, but you know, the good news is that it's not going to be too far along. It's not going to be too far away until we actually see that event. About 1,007 years plus from today, right? About 1,007 plus years from today, we're going to see it. Amen. Because we know that we're at the end. Okay. We know that we're at the end. We're on the cusp of the, as the hat says, rapture. And the rapture will be the kickoff event for the great and dreadful day of the Lord. Okay. That comes like a thief in the night. Better have some oil in your lamp. Amen. Better have some oil when the thief comes. Okay. He's coming like a thief in the night. He's not a thief though. Amen. Okay. He's not a thief though. He'd be coming like a thief in the night. And you know how a thief comes. Okay. Thief coming to see if anybody's in darkness. Thief coming to see if anybody in darkness. Okay. Break into your house. Uh-oh. Shake his sand, right? Break into your house on that shaky sand. Break into your house now. Shake his sand. Amen. You see, but for us, hallelujah, because we got light, we got the oil. Okay, we're going to be with him because he's light. And all light is going to come with him when the restraint is removed, when the Holy Spirit, okay, in us, transforms us in the twinkling of an eye, in a moment, right, to be caught up, our pot sold, raptured. Okay, in the clouds to meet our Lord in the air, and the restraint is removed, and now here comes darkness. Okay, the Bible talks about that great and dreadful day as a day of darkness. Okay, shall not the day of the Lord be darkness and not light? Even very dark with no brightness in it. Okay, terrible day. The world ain't seen nothing yet. Terrible day. The world ain't seen nothing yet. People think it's bad today. Yes, you know, it's trouble. Okay, the Bible tells us in the world we're going to have tribulation, right? There's trouble. There's tribulation. But God says, be of good cheer, right? For he's overcome the world. And the Bible tells us that immediately after the tribulation of those days, right? The tribulation that we're in right now. Okay, the same type of tribulation that John said that he was our companion in. He's our companion in tribulation. Okay, the same type of trouble that God said we would have, right? But the Bible says the gates of hell will not prevail. Amen. Well, God said immediately after the tribulation of those days, the sun's going to be darkened. Moon's going to be turned to blood. How come? Glory cloud. Yeah. Cloud coming. Okay. The day of the Lord is a day of clouds, right? Cloud coming, okay? Cloud coming. God said he's going to darken the earth in the clear day. He's going to make the sun go down at noon, right? Cloud coming, okay? Jesus coming. And on that very moment, we're going to be out of here. But for everybody left behind, well, why see everybody knees weak like water? Okay. Why I see everybody hand limp? Okay. Why I see everybody baldness on their head? Why I see it? Why I see it now? Okay. Why I see everybody sackcloth on their lawn? Why I see it? Okay. Why I see it now? Okay. Dark and cloudy day. Okay. Why everybody wailing? Why am I howling? What's going on around here? Little dark, little cloudy. Okay. Little dark, little cloudy. Okay. Cloudy, dark day. See? But praise God that we're going to escape. And we ain't got to see that time. See, this is a day of trouble. Okay. Trouble now. But praise God, hallelujah. Got a little bit off track, got a little fired up. Started talking about the day of the Lord. You know, that was my calling. Still is my calling, you know. And I got tons of videos on this page about it. And as the Lord leads, I'll continue to speak about it. because it's coming. And there's only one way of escape. And the way of escape is to call upon the name of Jesus. Amen. So I love you, family of God. And until we talk again, if the Lord says the same, I'll see you here tomorrow. So rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Maranatha. Amen.